The recording has started.
Okay, today is the skill development papers class, and this is the extension lecture on film making. And this lecture is being organized by Department of English, USOL, Punjab University, Chandigarh. So today we are going to learn about film making basics of, I have two lectures with you. So today is the first lecture in this series, and we'll be talking about film making. As your teachers have told me, you have to prepare 5 minutes feature film or small film clip regarding your subject or whatever topic you like. So I will be discussing about nitty-gritties of film making. How to do film making. So when we talk about film making, like as you are a student of literature, you play with words, and I would say you are wordsmiths. Basically, it's just like creative writing. In creative writing, you play with words, and basically you take help of verbal storytelling by using words. And when we talk about film making, basically we use visuals for storytelling, and this is a very powerful medium. And with the advent of a lot of social media platforms, film making is day by day becoming more popular. And if you see YouTube, millions of videos are posted every year. So basically, any film making process involves 3 steps. First is pre-production, then is production, and final is post-production. Basically, pre-production is the ideation phase where you do all your homework, and in production stage you go for shooting, and then the last stage is post-production, in which we do editing and add our sound or special effects in the post-production part. And this is basically these days dealt with computers. We require workstations for working on post-production. So first and foremost thing in film making is you need to have a concept, what you are going to shoot. Then, or in other words, we can say you should identify the theme of your film. Then you should have a very clear idea to which genre your film is going to belong. And you have to work on your story idea, like what we are going to film and what will be the story. So the concept or the thought process or the words are very important. As you are a student of literature, so story becomes very, very, very important as far as film making is concerned. Before you pick up your camera and start filming, you should have story in your mind and what you want to portray, and that will make your film very attractive and very meaningful. So first and foremost, the important part is you have to plan. And when we talk about planning, you have to think. And for film making, if you are a student of literature, and you must be amazed what we have to think for film making. There is a lot of thinking involved in film making, and without thinking process, film making is incomplete. So when you plan or think, you have to plan for your budget, then the duration of the film. You have to decide or plan for the location and the equipment, what kind of equipment you are going to use. So these things are very important, where your thinking process or thought process or critical thinking is involved in filmmaking. So as I've already discussed, so planning involves budget. If you have sufficient amount of money, you can hire good camera person, DOP, and you can go for good post-production work, and your film will be great. And the other important thing you have to keep in mind is the duration of the film. Is it a 5-minute film? Is it a 10-minute film? Or is it 15-minute film? Or is it a 1.5 half hour film or 3 hours film, or maybe episodes of maybe 20 minutes, there are 100 episodes. So whatever you're shooting, your storyline duration plays an important role, and it has direct correlation to the budget. The duration of the film and budget are correlated. Longer the duration of the film, more money and input, financial inputs you require. And after duration, the other thing is location is very important. Either you are shooting in the exterior or outdoors, or are you shooting indoors or in interiors? So location is also very important. You have to select the location for your film. That is very, very important. And you should have a very crystal clear idea before starting shooting. Okay, this is the plan of the film, and either we have to shoot in the exterior or interiors. And equipment also matters. Are you going to use the professional camera, professional sound equipment for recording the sound, and the cameraman? So equipment is also very important. Like here is a model or a presenter using a light and a camera here, and this is a Canon professional camera for shooting films, and this is cinema really used for shooting feature films. So if you're using professional camera or lighting, what kind of lighting you are using, what kind of setup you are. Or computer, webcam for live streaming their lectures or recording their lectures. And on the other end, on the very extreme, we have very professional cameras, the television cameras, which are used. These are very expensive cameras. They cost around 25 lakhs or maybe 30 lakhs easily. So these are very, very expensive cameras. These are basically most of the time used indoors. These professional studio cameras. And in equipment, we can add the list of drone or the for aerial photography, or using gimbals for cinematic effects. This DSLR is tethered to the gimbal, and professional sound recording mic is there. And these are the accessories which hold gimbal in place, and we can record beautiful videos, jerk-free videos with the help of gimbals. And sometimes if you plan to shoot underwater, so accordingly you have to select your equipment also. Camera with underwater, they require special kind of casing. This waterproof casing, so knobs are attached to the casing, from where you can control various features of your camera and you can shoot underwater. So these things are important when we talk about planning. You have to think about budget of your film, duration, location, and the kind of equipment you are going to use for your film. So budget is important, then duration, location of the film, it's either exterior or interior, then equipment you are going to use, the lighting equipment or the camera equipment you are going to use. So all these things come into plan. So before starting film, you have to plan accordingly, what kind of budget you have, what kind of equipment you are going to use. Maybe you can use action camera, GoPro, Sony, and lot many other brands are giving wonderful results when we talk about professional video film making. So these are very handy cameras. These are the action cameras. You can also use these cameras if you have one for film making, or you can trust your mobile phone for film making. This can also work for shooting 5 minute to 7 minute clip. So you have to decide on your equipment, what kind of equipment you have. Either you can borrow a camera from your friend. So how the journey begins? If we talk about the journey of filmmaking, so how it starts, as you are a student of literature, you are well versed with a lot of words and you play with words, basically your wordsmiths. So the film making story starts with the story only, and you have to decide on the story or the plot of your film, and it should have a good beginning, good middle and good end. Your film should be very captivating, and it will be captivating only if you have a good storyline or good plot. So just give lot of thought process into the quality of story you are going to build, and from verbal it has to be there will be metamorphosis from verbal to visual medium when we talk about filmmaking. So first and foremost thing in filmmaking is you have to write a script or screenplay. Basically, what is screenplay or script? As you are a student of literature, basically you are really exposed to rich vocabulary, many words you're well versed with, and you have a very fertile imagination, because as a student of literature you have very wide reading. And for filmmaking, you have to write a screenplay or script. Basically, screenplay could be original idea, it's your original story, or you can adapt from the existing piece of writing. Maybe you have read a story in a magazine or from a book. You can adapt and prepare your script. Basically, a person who writes screenplay or script, they are called screenwriters. So the scripts are, or the screenplay are written by the screenwriters. And for every television serial, feature movie, even for many documentaries, if you write screenplay or script, it will be very helpful for the final product of the film. So, and this could be a profession, this could be a professional opportunity for you to become a screenwriter also. If you learn the art of writing screenplay or script, so there's a lot of demand in film industry, in the television industry, and even you can start your own production house where you can write, and your skill of writing screenplay or script will help. So I would like to share, she is Jyoti Kapoor. She's a screenwriter or a script writer, and she has written the film Good News. The Bollywood hit Good News. She's my classmate, and she has passed mass communication from Punjab University. So as a student of literature, you are studying English. You can also pursue a career in writing. So if you just see the press coverage, Karnal scriptwriter makes it to Bollywood. So a lot of media coverage has been done if you just check the YouTube channel. So this is a motivation for you as a student of literature. There was a little bit of controversy also, because Jyoti Kapoor's name was dropped from the list, in the nomination list for the best story for the film Batari Ho, and a lot of newspaper coverage was there about the incident, and she was a person behind the story of Badai Ho, this film, and the blockbuster movie Good News. So the movie starts with a screenplay or the script, and here your language skills, your whatever knowledge you have acquired about grammar, about writing, creative writing, that comes into play when you write a script. And the person who write script or screenplay, these are called screenwriters. Now moving ahead, you will be having lecture by Pali Pupinder sir, Professor Pali Pupinder. He is also a script writer, and he is a film director also. His movie Gurmukh is coming. So he will be also delving into screenwriting or script writing. So screenplay or screenwriting, script writing. So what screenplay or script involves? What are part of screenplay or script? Basically, whatever character or actor is seen on the film screen or in the frame of your movie, all the movements, all the actions, all the expression, the facial expressions or the body language and the dialogues are narrated in the screenplay or script. When you write a script or screenplay, you write it in detail, what the character is doing, where he is moving, what are his actions, what is body language, what kind of expressions or emotions that character is expressing, and the dialogues you mention in the script. So dialogues are very important part. You have to, from story, you build up dialogues, and basically it's just like if you have done some theater, there is script where every artist or actor is given dialogues and they rehearse it and perform on the stage. Similarly, for screenplay or script, you have to write dialogues also. So, and as a student of literature, it will be a very creative exercise for you for writing dialogues. So, when we talk about screenplay or script, the first thing is scene heading or slug line. One and the same thing. Either you can see, say, scene heading or slug line. So, scene heading or slug line, what do you mean by that? Is basically, if you just look at the image on the right hand side, this is a picture on the right hand side. Maybe we are shooting this frame, and then we give a short description that indicates where and when the scene takes place. This is called scene heading or slug line. So it could have three elements. Either the scene could be shot, this film scene could be shot interior or exterior, or in other words, we can say indoor or outdoors, or it could be both interior and exterior. Both the scene could involve both the locations. And the second thing is location, and third thing is time of the day. So whatever you are shooting, you have to mention in your slug line in the screenplay. So if we talk about the slug line, basically slug lines are always mentioned in all caps. Here you look, all caps is here, and use a forward slash if the scene takes place in two or four locations. You put forward slash if the scene takes place like this. Second scene, this is a forward slash. So you put forward slash here. So here, EXT full stop means exterior. So slug line is basically the slug line here is, this is a slug line. And slug line says this shot is to be shot in exterior. Ye outdoors ki baat kar rahe hum, exterior ki baat kar rahe. And second thing is location. Maybe we are sitting in Mumbai and the location is Marine Drive. So we have mentioned in the slug line the location. And the third thing is time of the day, it is afternoon time. So we have mentioned the time of the day also. Looking at this cloudy sky, this is the afternoon time. So when we talk about slug line or scene heading, so this is a scene heading in a script. So this is very important. Before you start filming, if you have your script ready, script is basically written on a piece of paper and you can take a printout, and it's very easy to shoot the scenes once you have your proper script. And the first thing is you have to write a scene heading, and or is this is also called the slug line, and it mentioned either it's interior or exterior location and time of the day. So first thing we have covered, it covers this slug line. The short description is about either it's interior, exterior, about the location and about the time, where and when. It answers two questions: where and when these slug lines or the scene headings when we talk about screenplay. And here is an interesting slug line or heading. The slug line is mentioned here. It is written interior, library, day. Interior, that is, it's not outdoors. We are inside a building. And location is given library. And time of the day, basically it's daytime, not night time. You can add afternoon or maybe evening time, daytime. So I've simply mentioned day. So this is an interior shoot. And the other thing in a script is you write action. Now, what is action? Action is, it describes what is seen and heard on the screen. So it describes the video element, whatever video we are seeing, and the audio also, the action, what you are hearing, and audio part and video part are, when we talk about script, action covers video also and your audio also. So on the top it is slug line, exterior, lake, sunrise. It's a time of sunrise, and it's by the lake, and the girl is on the banks of the lake. She's riding a horse, and here is the action: the girl riding the horse next to the lake. Horse is full of energy, in joyful mood, splashing the water while running on the banks of the lake. The morning sun painting the scene golden. So whatever action is happening, you mention in your script. And then next comes the character. Character is basically the actors in the film. So when we talk about character, when the first time character appears in the script, the character name is in caps or bold, and age is parenthetical. When we write character, here we are writing character in the backdrop of golden sky because of sunrise, athletic, confident Jessica, 16. We have to write in capital. And the age of the character also, came riding the horse on the bank of the lake. There was bond between Jessica and horse. So age is written in parenthetical form. And we give description. We describe about the character, how she looks. We have mentioned the word athletic, confident. So in this picture, if you her fitness level, she's very confidently riding the horse, and her name is Jessica, and she's 16 years old. So we define the character in our screenplay or script. And if the character's name in the action line, just write the name, nothing to it. Jessica leaves for riding. And if we are writing a dialogue for the character, it should be caps centered above the dialogue. Here is a dialogue. And you have to write the name of the character above the dialogue. Here is a dialogue. And you have to write name above the dialogue. And when we talk about dialogue, this is a dialogue. And it is centered. The character is capped, all caps. And it comes above the dialogue. And voiceover, sometimes the character talks, but the other characters can't hear. Usually, this is an inner voice or narration. Maybe she's thinking, Jessica is thinking, and she's talking to herself, and you want to show on your movie. And while writing a script, you will write, maybe the dialogue is, voiceover is, one day I will go to national championship. This is a voiceover, and you write the character, and in brackets you write voiceover. So when you write a script, if you're writing a script or typing a script, the final script look like this. Film script look like this. Here is a character, name of the character, and here is a dialogue, what the character is going to speak. Here is a character, and here is a dialogue. Here is a dialogue, and here is a slug line. Slug line is basically gives you the idea of the scene. It is written interior shot, and character's living room place is there, and sunrise is happening, and this is giving description of, and this is the character, and they are giving description. Here is a character, and here are the dialogues, and dialogues are always what they are saying. So it is defining action. This is how the script is typed or script is written. Then comes storyboard. Storyboard is very important. And the script requires a lot of time to learn. There is a Film Institute Pune and many other film institutes where filmmakers go and learn how to write script. There are short-term courses, long-term courses. How to write script, all the technicalities and nitty-gritties are discussed there. And when Professor Pali Bhupinder will be sharing his lecture with you, he's also a script writer. Right. So as a filmmaker, you have to learn this skill also. Like as a literature student, you learn about grammar, you learn about phonetics. Similarly, for filmmaking, you should have a basic idea of the script. And this will really help you in making a good film. And after script comes storyboard. Storyboard is also very important. Storyboard is basically, in storyboard, we place visuals, sequence of the visuals we select, and we plan about audio. Should we add dialogue? Should we add voiceover? Should we add background music? And about the scene. Either this is an exterior scene or this frame or this shot. Maybe this is the first shot, this is the second shot, this is a third shot, and this is a fourth shot. So you have to, and any special visual effect you are going to add in your film, duration of the shot. Maybe this first shot, if you are using a pan, this is for 5 seconds. So in storyboards, we write down everything. either we are zooming out, zooming in, then camera movement, camera angle and camera shot. All these things are written in a visual format, and this visual format is basically a storyboard. And sometimes you require professional help also for preparing a professionally. There are a lot of softwares also, but professional help you can always see for preparing a good storyboard. So, starting our journey in filmmaking, the first and foremost foundation, what we say, is you have to, when we talk about filmmaking, about shooting, is you should have a good understanding about shot size. What is this and how we can understand about shot size is basically these are the various shot types, shot size, establishing shot, master shot, wide shot, and when we talk about full shot, medium shot, or medium full shot, medium shot, medium close-up shot, close-up shot, extreme close-up shot, these are of an individual. Usually these are of individual or a thing, maybe a there is a prop, we can use it. So this is related to individual or prop, and this is basically for establishing the location or setting up the mood where we are located. So for the location purpose we use this shot size. So shot size, again you have to look for this, either this is a medium shot or establishing shot, establishing shot. So here is an establishing shot, and if you just see, this is the master shot, and or you can say a wide shot. This is full length shot, wide. This is again full length shot, medium, medium shots. This is extreme close up shot, extreme close up. This is close up shot. So this is how, this is your establishing shot. This is your master shot. This is wide angle shot. This is full shot. Whole individual is seen in the, so whatever you want to show on your television screen, you have to select the shot size. Your actor, either it should be medium full shot, this much length is covered. Then if we talk about medium shot, then medium close up, and this is close up. Here face is almost visible, and in extreme close up you can see the feature of the person. If we talk about the features, so this is extreme close up or ECU. In short we say ECU. This is close up shot, EU. This is medium close up, MCU. This is medium shot, MS. This is medium full shot, FS. Again, this is FS. Depending upon your story, what you want to narrate, you have to select the shot size. What you want to fill your frame, what you want to show on your television screen when you are shooting. So as a director of photography or a director or by making a film, these shots are very important and you have to select these shots. And they make your visual storytelling more compelling and more interesting. So establishing shot is here, master shot is here, and wide angle shot is here. And moving ahead, full shot, medium full shot, medium shot, medium close up, close-up and extreme close-up. Now I would like to share a video with you which explains the importance of shot size and where they are used, and it talks about all these shots, sub-shot, master shot, then wide angle, wide shot, full shot. So I will play a video.
Shot choice that help establish the rhythm, tone, and meaning of the scene. Knowing which shot will be the most aesthetically and dramatically valuable for a given scene should be the highest priority for both a director and a DP. In this video, we'll be examining essential shot sizes. As we go, we'll populate a shot list in Studio Binder as a sort of cheat sheet the next time you need to create one. Now, let's get to the shots. The most common visual element to open a scene, or even an entire film, is the establishing shot. It is typically wide enough to establish the geography, time of day, show the scale of subjects in relation to their environment, and is often used to transition between scenes. With genres like science fiction, where entirely new worlds need to be introduced, the establishing shot is crucial. Blade Runner 2049 opens with a series of establishing shots. You get the first impressions of the near future Earth with industrial and futuristic farms outside the city. So remember, an establishing shot is a crucial introductory component of any scene. It can mark a transition to a new location, or introduce crucial details about the location or world. The establishing shot is often followed up by the master shot, or simply the master. Like the establishing shot, a master shot confirms the location and geography of the scene. It also clarifies which characters are in the scene and where they are in relationship to each other.
Go on, sit down. Talk to each other.
Here we see a master from The Godfather Part 2 framing the Corleone family around a dinner table.
Hey, Sally, get in here.
The majority of this scene is played in the master to emphasize the family's close-knit relationship.
Conscientious blood, remember that.
Until Michael drops some devastating news.
Well, if you don't feel like that, why don't you just quit college and go to join the army?
I did. I enlisted in the Marines.
Why do you think about it? Pop had to pull a lot of strings to get you a deferment.
I didn't ask for deferment. I didn't want it.
But it also helps make Michael split from the family visual from this to this. And we feel the impact around them that much more. Remember, the master captures the scene playing out in its entirety, providing the editor with something to cut out to, if necessary. Moving on. Wide shot, WS.
Let me tell you about my boat.
The wide shot positions subjects far from the camera to visually represent their relationship to their environment. This is distinct from the establishing shot, which is about location. The wide shot is principally concerned with the scale of the subject.
I'm finished.
It can be used when you need to make subjects appear lost, lonely, or overwhelmed, or comment on a subject's relationship to their environment. In this wide shot from Phantom Thread, we can see the character Alman Reynolds, dwarfed by a massive wall. Paul Thomas Anderson could have ended the scene with close-ups to capture the character's emotions. But by ending with a wide shot here, we can consider Alma and Reynolds together, yet isolated from the world around them. Music will need to establish these special relationships with the subject. Make statements using distance, depth, or size. Our next subject, foreshot. When a subject's entire body reaches from the top to the bottom edges of the frame, the shot is defined as full. With a full shot, it's not necessary to put the subject in the center of the frame, but notice how often this is the case. This example is effective because it is tight enough to tell a story with the character's face, but wide enough to further the story by observing her entire body, posture, and wardrobe. So remember, a full is composed head to toe, and you can use them when you need to make statements about a subject's physicality and present a character in all their glory. Moving on. Medium full shot, cowboy. The medium full shot is arranged from the top of the subject's head to just below their waist. It is sometimes referred to as a cowboy shot based on height of gun holsters. Here we can see complementary angles from The Favorite, composed in medium fulls. The cowboy angle on the character, Lady Sarah, is particularly strong and confrontational. This isn't a Western and features no holsters, but it's hard not to think of cowboys and firearms are deployed like this. Use it when you need to present a subject as confident, dangerous, or confrontational, especially when weapons might be drawn. Moving on. Medium shot, MS. Perhaps the most popular shot size in all of cinema is the medium shot. But why? Because it's more of a neutral shot, neither dramatic like a close-up or distancing like a wide shot. It captures the subject in a size similar to how we interact with people. Will you hold still? The typical composition of a medium shot starts above the waist, but below the chest, and ends just above the head. Shot sizes deployed in animated films function under the same compositional rules.
Oh, hello.
Let's look at an example to better illustrate this. In this scene from Coco, Miguel watches a film starring his idol. The medium shot composition accommodates quite a bit. The props from Miguel's shrine, the detail on the TV screen, and Miguel's reactions to it. It's an intimate moment as we observe Miguel's joy, along with the objects of his affection in a single frame.
Follow my heart.
So remember, the typical composition of a medium shot starts above the waist, but below the chest, and ends just above the head. Use it when you need to dig into a subject's eyes without losing their physicality or environment, or utilize a true middle ground approach that is neither jarring nor especially dramatic. Our next subject, medium close-up shot, MCU. When a shot frames a subject from mid-chest to just above their head, it is referred to as a medium close-up. Medium close-ups are about reducing distraction and prioritizing story and character details.
Why don't you start right now and get the fuck out of here?
Use it when you need to get intimate with a subject without losing their physicality.
Perhaps I treated you too harshly.
Here, the villainous Thanos snaps his fingers during the climactic moments of Avengers Endgame. With this shot size, we have room for the Infinity Gauntlet, and Thanos' look of cruel satisfaction in thinking he has won. But when he fails, this medium close-up is designed to also capture his reaction. Remember, a medium close-up is roughly head to chest. Are you ready for it? It's the close-up. See you.
Here's Johnny!
A Of course, the most powerful visual weapon for highlighting a change in motion or dramatic beat on screen. Close-ups are most often arranged at eye level, better to dig into the windows of the soul. In this shot size, we have a front row seat for a character's thoughts and feelings. You got me?
Yes, anything.
The close-up is about empathy and illustrates how dramatically effective it can be in a time of decision or anxiety. Our final category, extreme close-up shot, ECU. An extreme close-up, or ECU, frames a subject to isolate a specific area. This could be lips, ears, or nose, but the eyes are typically the focus. Like here in Kill Bill Volume 1. As the bride is swarmed by the crazy 88, we cut back and forth between their entry points and her frantic eye. But when the function of a specific prop or an intimate detail is necessary, filmmakers will often rely on the insert shot. Inserts are most commonly used to highlight and isolate something crucial to the narrative. So remember, an extreme close-up or an insert shot is one of the greatest tools for emphasis. It is the most intimate, dramatic, and potentially startling of all shot sizes. So, this is our shot list made in Studio Finder so far. It has all of the most common shot sizes you can reference the next time you need to create a shot list. You can find a link to the full shot list in the description.
So we have seen the importance of short films, how they impact our film, and this is a very important tool in your storyboard, or it can also help you in imagining while you're writing your script or script. So moving ahead, the second part is about camera framing, and in camera framing basically we talk about individuals. Either you can take one individual in a frame, there are two individuals in a frame, then three or four individuals are in a frame, or five individuals are in a frame, or there's a lot of crowd, lot of individuals are there, this is a crowd shot. And these are more personal or highlighting emotions, over the shoulder shot, point of view shot, and insert shot. The last video have given a brief description about the insert shot. So this is how, this is 1% shot, 2%, 3, 4, 5 crowd shot. And if you just look here, over the shoulder, this is the over the shoulder shot, and this is point of view, and this is insert shot. So single shot, two shot, three shot, four, five, crowd shot, over the shoulder, point of view, and insert shot. So again, I will like to share a video with you explaining the concept of single, two shot, three shot, and with examples from the movies. This video is by Studio Binder. I'm playing the video.
Let's get into the proper frame of mind.
And these are the most commonly used framing options to cover action in the scene.
I've never seen anything like this.
Signals,
which can be clean or dirty. Two shot. Over the shoulder. Point of view. And finally, the insert. Our first framing convention, the single. A single shot features one character alone in the frame. The individual character is the primary focus. But there are two ways to frame a single. A clean single is when no part of any other character is visible in frame. It's best used when you want to convey a character's isolation. Whereas a dirty single includes a limited presence from another character in the frame. And don't forget that singles, like all of the framing options, can be combined with any of the shot sizes we covered in the last video, whether it's a close-up, a medium shot, or a wide shot. The single still applies. When two characters are visible together in frame, this is called the two shot.
Don't say if you want to live long.
The orientation of the characters to one another can vary, but to be considered a two shot, both faces must be clearly visible. The two shot is all about creating a visual relationship between two characters. This relationship might be affectionate, contentious, or even an action match. When more characters are added to the frame, the terminology adjusts to three shots.
With the sickness, you mother, get up.
Four shot.
Down with the sickness, you mother.
And so on.
Come on, get down with the sickness. Open up your head and let it fall.
There is no official limit on how high this number can go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
A number in this would be overkill. Best to just call it a crowd shot. Remember that no matter how many characters you include in a single frame, you are creating a relationship between them. The most common and useful way of covering a conversation is the over-the-shoulder shot. The OTS shot acts like a hybrid between a single and a two-shot, and similar to a single, we're often only focusing on one character at a time. From these OTS angles, we get perspectives from both sides, and a sense that we are included in the moment.
Can I help you?
I hope so. I'm an old friend of George's. Thought I'd stop and say hello.
When you want the audience to experience the perspective of a character, it can be effective to frame up a point of view or POV shot. The idea of the POV can cover a wide range of perspectives. A person, an alien, a camera, a disembodied spirit, or even a shark. In many cases, a POV shot is also paired with POV audio, so we can see what they see and hear what they hear. The insert shot is not just about going extremely tight on a detail. The way the information is framed is often even more important than how prominent it is on screen. Inserts can also be combined with POV shots, a first-person perspective. Or are we looking at the insert shot from a third-person perspective? Or a hybrid frame like this, both an elegant insert and an effective POV. We've covered the most common type of camera framing, But now, let's put it all together. Let's look at Bong Joon-ho's Parasite. This sequence of scenes is about the physical and ideological connections between family and others. Watch how the director ties them together through filming decisions. An ultra-wide four-shot of the Kims in the Park family's backyard. An insert shot of four whiskey glasses being filled. A medium four-shot of the Kim family. A hybrid four-shot, OTS, POV. A close-up dirty symbol. A dirty symbol. A dirty two-shot. A dirty OTS shot. A complimentary OTS. A dirty single. A full full shot. A two shot. Pans over to a different two shot. The pan continues to a three shot. A dirty single, a dirty single, an OTS shot, a clean single, and over to frame another clean single. Lastly, a wide four shot. As we've seen, the way you frame a shot helps guide the scene in the desired direction. Once you understand what you want to achieve in scenes, you can decide how best to frame your subject. Plan out your shots in detail before production. And shortlisted using Studio Vivo. If you're looking to create and collaborate,
this is clearly the short size. We talk about the short size. The camera framing. How we frame the camera. If you have any doubts, you have any questions, switch on your mic or put it over your chat box or message position.
Hello? बजे मेरी भी मीटिंग है बस उन्होंने कुछ सवाल थे कि जो आई कैन ऑल्सो आंसर आई लास्क देम टू वेट फॉर फर्दर लैक्चर्स है ना हाँ उन्होंने कह दूँ कि जो थोड़े बाकी स्क्वेरीज है दे आर थ्री मोर लै हाँ जी हाँ समअप कर दूँ उन्होंने भी कह दूँ कि जो सवाल पूछे दे आर थ्री मोर लैक्चर्स देयर विल बी आंसर्ड कि सब्जेक्ट किदा चूज करने ड्यूरेशन एंड एवरीथिंग कर दो कर दो। हाँ हाँ जी कर दो।
So dear students, today we have learned about filmmaking, basics about filmmaking, and this we started with basically filmmaking is a visual storytelling method, and film production can be divided into pre-production, production and post-production, and your planning is very important, what kind of equipment you are using. And when we talk about the genre of the film, it starts with a story. If you have a really good story, your film will be really engaging and well entertaining. And the from story, we convert story into screenplay or scripts. When we write a script, and I've given examples of prominent script writers, young script writers, Jyoti Kapoor, Pani Pukunda sir, and in scripts you write movement, action, expressions, and the first thing is slug line in the script, where you define either the shot is an exterior or interior place, location and time of the day. Suppose this is a shot and we define this is exterior, the rain drive afternoon, or this is a shot, this is interior, and location is library and daytime. And you, in the scripts, when we talk about this script or screenplay, you define action also. You write in words, like verbal picture to the action. The girl is riding the horse, and you define the character also. What is the character you want to frame? This frame in the movie, like what the character is doing, details about the character, and the age of the character, and the dialogue also are written in the script or the screenplay. You write the dialogue also. What the character is going to speak, and this is how the final script look like. And there is a technical way of writing scripts, and there is a professional person you can do or you can pursue and learn more about screenplay or script writing. This is part of filmmaking. And then the next part is giving visual representation. Preparing a storyboard, this is a very interesting thing and it's a very detailed topic. So I'm not picking up, I've just given a small to you. And we start with shot size. So when you pick up your camera, you have to decide which shot size you require. Either it's a, mostly the film starts with establishing shot and master shot. It captures the motion, then wide shot. And these shots, basically when we say, from full shot to extreme closure, they are revolving around the individual. And when we talk about camera framing, 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%, 5% or crowd shot, or over the shoulder. This shot is basically used to highlight the dialogue going on between two persons. One camera is on this side and one camera is on this side. They are recording the emotional details and the facial expression of the individuals or the actors in the frame. And this is point of view, and this is insert shot. We take a very close up and insert. And this was all about framing. So today we have done the basics of filmmaking. And tomorrow we are going to move ahead. We will talk about camera angles, camera movements, about camera lenses and understanding light, which is very important for filmmaking. So we will continue tomorrow. I hope if you have any queries, just write it down and give it to Dr. Bhavinder, and I will take it up tomorrow. Thank you.